Four games over the next 8 days, the Cincinnati Bearcats can't afford to get cocky about their national ranking. After all, fat cats have a hard time pressing and shooting jumpers. Tonight, the Raging Cajuns of Southwest Louisiana. Is it fair to say Bob Huggins is full of hot air? I mean that affectionately. Cats rolling after the Martin miss. Alvin Mitchell finds Melvin Levitt, and Melvin climbs the ladder. He's a highlight maker. Freshman Donald Little had his best game as a Bearcat with 11 points. Booyah, the 6'10 center, was a presence on both ends of the court. The big block and the kick to the helicopter, who is a very high jumper. Mel led UC with 22 points. The Raging Cajuns made a run, but in the end, UC had just too much firepower. They moved to 6-0 with a 91-65 win.
Early this week, I went and talked to the coach, told him I was losing my confidence. And we had about a 2-hour talk. And now he told me just play. He told me he don't care when I shoot or how I shoot it, just play.
He just played. The Bearcats host Nicholls State Monday night. That game also right here.
I'm very anxious. I just want to get into the groove with the team, you know, and hopefully I won't slow them down. Just get back and, you know, start to win some games.
Well, it was a UC debut for Jermaine Tate tonight at the Shoe, but the man who stole the show against Little Nicholls State, Kenyon Martin, 22 points, 13 boards, and 4 serious blocks. Bob Huggins preaching to the troops, spreading the word, according to Bob, and Tate getting into the mix off the miss board. Back up with a follow and the foul, but he had 4 fouls in the first 12 minutes of the game. Meanwhile, Cats doing what they do outside to Mel Levitt, 3 of his 14. Mel acting up a tad, but as noted, this is Martin Knight behind the D for the jam, and get a load of what's coming up. Pins it on this end, plays point, runs the court, and delivers to Aaron McGee. Big finish. That put the Cats up by 33. They win 82-48. Dan Hoard has more from the Shoe.
Thanks, Greg. Kenyon Martin had a huge impact on both ends of the court tonight, including a season-high 22 points. This was your first double-figure scoring game since the opener against Rhode Island. Were you at all concerned about the number of shots you had been getting?
I was getting the looks. I just was passing up shots, and I figured tonight, if I'm going to play the next 2 games, if I'm going to help my team win, I got to come out and just get my shots up and get comfortable with shooting the ball again. That was all.
And the shots you were getting, you were making, you hit your first 7.
I was just concentrating a little more on just getting the ball up and just following through on my jump shot and just getting in position on the block to score and just trying to be a factor.
On the defensive end, 4 block shots, nothing new about that, but 6 steals, that's a career high for you, and it shows the defensive impact you have not only under the basket, but all 90 feet of the court.
I was just trying to be like in the passing lanes, just trying to take things away. I got my hands on a lot of balls tonight, the ones that I didn't steal, my teammates got. And it was just a matter of me being out there and just being very active, I would say.
All right, it was fun to watch as the Bearcats beat Nicholls State by...
Seen on ESPN and in person by Randy Moss, Chris Carter, and that less famous guy in the middle. The guy in the middle for Minnesota, Joel Prisbilla. The rebound, Mitch Onstad. At the other end, Minnesota outscored Cincy 10-0 on fast break points in the first half. Minnesota, however, down 1 at the half. Kenyon Martin, however, missed much of the second half due to foul trouble for Cincinnati. And we're tied with 1:24 left. Quincy Lewis for 3. Minnesota up 3. 30 seconds left. Cincinnati comes up with a loose ball. Michael Horton to Melvin Levitt for 3, no, but Jermaine Tate, yes, emphatically. Cincy down just 1. Tate on the offensive end, now on the defensive end. 20 seconds left, Minnesota by 1. Kevin Clark driving, Tate draws the charge. He hit 2 free throws, put Cincy up 1. 10 seconds left. Kyle Sandin works himself free for a 3 and hits it. Puts Minnesota up 2 with 6.5 seconds left. Cincinnati coming the other way. They beat Duke in the final seconds, you might remember. Melvin Levitt in the lane, the floater. We're tied. We're going to overtime. In overtime, the Bearcats are up by 1. Alvin Mitchell keeps the ball alive, comes back in, and then nails a 3-pointer to put Cincinnati up 4. 50 seconds left in overtime. It's a 3-point Cincinnati lead. Minnesota pressing. Terrence Simmons steals, converts. Minnesota down 1. And with 9 seconds left,
Still down one, Minnesota with a chance. Kevin Clark. Time ticking down. Drives, spins, shoots, can't make it. Ball's loose, and that'll wrap it up. Cincinnati wins a great, great overtime battle. 62-61 is your final. Right after the game, Bob Huggins said, "I'm glad it's over. They are good. This was a great win for us." Alvin Mitchell led Cincy with 12 points, 8 of them in the overtime, and all of them after the half. Both teams shot under 40% from the field. The Bearcats remained perfect in 6 games against Minnesota under Huggins.
Night for UC fans, Bearcats against the Running Rebels from UNLV. Alvin Mitchell to Jermaine Tate's a new combination. How about this one on the run? Mitchell, the alley-oop to Kenyon Martin, who had a fabulous night. Rebels, though, hung close. Brian Keefe is left alone, takes advantage and hits the 3. Bob Huggins says his team got passive a little in that second half. Nothing passive about this highlight. Steve Logan misses, but Mel Levitt follows with the rebound and slam. Mel had 19 while Pete Michael had 23, but this time he gives it up to Logan. Kenyon Martin, though, had an eye-popping night. 23 points, 11 rebounds, and a slew of block shots as the Bearcats stayed unbeaten with an 86-73 victory.
Off at the next level at the nightcap of the Las Vegas Shootout doubleheader. There's Mr. Marion, but in the first half it was UC's Kenyon Martin putting on the show. That dunk ties the game early. More from Kenyon Martin. Alvin Mitchell throws the lob and Martin does the rest. Bearcats lead by 3 at the half. Second half, UNLV trying to come back, but Martin says, "Get that out of here." Then Marion with the put back, but Kenyon Martin sends it the other way. UNLV battling back. Greedy Daniels outside, hits the 3. That cuts the Cincinnati lead to 5. In the end, though, Cincinnati just too much. Michael Horton to Melvin Levitt. 3 ball, corner pocket. Bearcats up by 9 as they finally pull this one out at the end. 86-73, the final. Bearcats now 9-0. That's their best start since opening 12-0 3 years ago. The Rebels now drop to 4-5, including 0-3 against ranked